good enough. The joint operation forces of Democratic Republic of Congo and UPDF combined with the earth moving objects to clear the road from Kamango via Mukakati and also via Semuliki Bridge to the place called Polese, that's a detach for FRDC. And as of now, as I'm talking now, the road is smooth from that stretch. And it is enabling now vehicles to move, and also traders, in fact, have increased in number. The road was opened, and it's now motorable. Now, logistics is moving smoothly, given the fact that the main supply route now affordable. Yes, the ground troops are deep to the jungles of Virunga Forest. That was launched a week, and we have overrun more than 15 ADF camps. Some that are large to accommodate a battalion plus strength. And also, we engaged with some small pockets of the enemy, thereby killing two ADF terrorists and also recovering two guns, one machine gun, which is commonly known as a PK, with 300 rounds of ammunition. So the operation is really going smoothly, and the offensive is ongoing. We hope that by tomorrow, Camp Yayua will have also been taken over. Very cordial, really, very cordial. Civilians and also the forces of FRDC are cooperating with us, and we are doing a noble job of ensuring that at least we realize the peace in the two countries. Otherwise, the cooperation between the forces is really very cordial, and they are giving us enough information about the whereabouts of the enemy pockets, and also we are informing them to give us at least info on the hideouts of these bad elements.
Then lastly, could you please elaborate for us that stretch from Busunga border to Semuliki? How far is that distance?
The distance is 20 kilometers, only that if at all to go through it, by then it was really bad that you would be like 40 kilometers away. But at the moment, the distance is really shortened because of the construction of that road, and as you can see at the moment, the traffic is really high.
Thank you.
given the fact that the road, being as clean as it was, it has enabled both the military logistics supplies and also the population, more especially the traders, really to move from Busunga, Kabango, Mukakati to Beni and coming back to B. So thanks to the to UPDF engineering brigade.
Operation Soldier is progressing very well, executed by Uganda People's Defense Forces and Force Armee de Congo, FRDC, the armed forces of the Democratic Republic of Congo, who have so far been able at least to reach all the camps that were previously occupied by the ADF, now calling themselves Islamic State in Central African Republic, ISCAP. At least so far, we have had 61 people surrendering and 34 captured, and we've also been able in our joint mobile operations to put out of action 34 of them and also recover two machine guns of the type called PK and over 300 rounds of ammunition. Our forces have also been able to dominate most of those positions where we were able to remove terrorists. It's not about capturing. We're not an occupational force. It is about removing the problem. We're not capturing areas. We're dominating area. We're dominating ground where these forces were operating from, jointly with FRDC. What we are doing is that we are doing intelligence, surveillance, target acquisition and reconnaissance activities to make sure that all positions that are very well known can be engaged by air and artillery. Then our ground forces are going to kill them up. We're not about capturing any territory.
Horrible.
We are mainly operating in North Kivu and Ituri region. Ugandan forces are operating from North Kivu. DRC forces are operating mainly in Ituri. We cannot go into the specifics for the purposes of security. So far, we have suffered one injury, a minor one. One soldier during those encounters. One soldier got minor injuries. Yeah. And as we speak, he has been very, very well stabilized and is back in operations in fact. The objective of NFO is to defeat the enemy's will, capacity, capabilities, and means of making war. We do not have to focus on an individual person. And that is exactly what we're doing. We shall do everything that it takes because we also have better means, will, capacity and capabilities. Absolutely, they are still a very dangerous group and they are continuing to commit atrocities in Congo among civilian soft targets. Now, what we have done is enforcing all our deployment along the borderline and also kept doing community mobilization to step up vigilance because we're aware, we have fixed that. They also here, they intend to cross into Uganda. But we want to fail them by our community mobilization. This has worked all over in other operations other than this one, and we are sure that they cannot in any way cross. So we are stepping up community mobilization and also reinforcing border deployment.